Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you can hear me through the wind, which is awesome because it made it cool. Today, we celebrate the addition of a seventh route to the Treasure Coast Connector. It is truly an honor to give thanks to all of those who have contributed to this effort. In the words of Jim Sorensen, a vision without action is called a daydream, but action without a vision is called a nightmare. I have experienced both. Through the diligence of those committed to the expansion of the transit system, the addition of Route 7 has finally, am I allowed to say, gone from a vision to a reality. We are thankful to all who have been with us every step of the way, and we would like to thank our funding partners from the state and local levels who have made this additional route possible. From FDOT, and we have Jane Piotrowski here today. Good morning. It is so good to see you. Haven't seen you in a while. The Board of County Commissioners has contributed, BOCC administration and staff, and there has been a lot of action on that end, I can tell you. Community Transit, they have done amazing things with this, and obviously the TPO, the Transportation Planning Organization. Through their dedication and diligence to put ideas and plans into action, through the support of our funding partners, St. Lucie County Transit System is expanding. Yes. And providing additional connections within our community and with our neighboring Indian River County. I just like to mention anecdotally, not too long ago, and I cannot remember where I was or who was talking, but I heard about a lovely lady who was visiting down in Port St. Lucie. And she got on the bus and she went shopping in Palm Beach Gardens. She said it was a lovely day. So the concept is there. And of course, when you mention traveling from Port St. Lucie to Palm Beach Gardens, you have to realize that in this county, if you live down there, you continue in a southerly direction. And if you live up here, you continue traveling in a northerly direction. Well, there's been no connection via transit. This takes care of that. And I am just thrilled to see it because, as has been indicated, it's been a long time coming. I think it will make a big difference, both to the residents and to businesses, because we can now have folks that can get themselves to work and to shopping and what have you. Through their dedication and diligence to put the ideas and plans into action, and I think I already said that part, this is so exciting. So now we'll be able, as I just said, to traverse all three counties, Martin, St. Lucie, and Indian River. I'd like to mention at this point in time, with all that in mind, there is a table back there which has a lot of information. It was suggested I might want to bring the information up and hold it up. No, I don't think I'm going to do that. If you will go back to the table, they have things carefully anchored and you can look at them back there. I mean, literally, takeaways and things that would be helpful to you. So you can either use the service or explain it to others who might have need. We have so many people here with us this morning. And at this time, I would like to proceed with my least favorite part of the ceremony, acknowledging dignitaries and representatives who have taken time out to come here, not because I don't really appreciate all these people and their attention, but because the likelihood that you will forget someone is very great. So I have, it says here, see list. We're going to try the list. First of all, we have our county administrator, Howard Tipton. He's over here. And actually, whom I should have mentioned first, but she's somewhere else on the list, Mayor Linda Hudson from the city of Fort Pierce, within the beautiful city of Fort Pierce. Things are happening in Fort Pierce, folks. We also have with us the Deputy County Administrator, Mark Satterly. And where is he? He's somewhere. There he is, waving at me. He won't stand up. I also have some of my colleagues, Commissioner Zadovsky, Commissioner Johnson, and Commissioner Mallory over here. We're just so glad they were all able to join us. We also have Daryl Drummond, the President and CEO of the Council on Aging St. Lucie. They're the ones that bring us community transit. We also have Gertrude Walker, the Supervisor of Elections, is here with us this morning. We don't want to miss her. And I see I'm highlighted, so I'm reassured that I am here. There's been some doubt about that from moment to moment. It's just such an honor, really, to be here this morning, just from a personal point of view. I grew up in a big place where they had big transit, and while we're not there yet, the improvements and the expansions that have happened in community transit over the years I've been in this community are just amazing. and really heartening, because how else are people going to get from place to place? And as our traffic grows, now I have been to cities and we don't really have traffic, guys, but we do have a lot of cars moving around, let's put it that way. And while it's great if you can hop in your car and get through the traffic, it's also great if you feel like you don't want to deal with it, you have some place to go and you can hop on the bus. It's amazing if you need to get to a job or to school or to a doctor's appointment or to shopping. I mean, these are all things that are part of the equation, and that's, I guess, why I'm just so pleased to see community transit growing. Thank you all for being here to help us celebrate. No one told me I was supposed to introduce Howard Tipton, our county administrator.
It is windy, but I'll tell you what, I'd take today over July any day of the week. This is summer has let its tenuous hand on us go, and I'm thankful. Well, good morning, everybody. It is a pleasure to be here. What a beautiful facility. What a beautiful place to go ahead and celebrate an addition to our transit system. So we start with giving thanks for having a facility like this as our base. Let me start by saying congratulations to all that have had a hand in making this new route possible. It takes many hands to make something like this work, and we are blessed to have a great team working in concert with our partners, and it's an overnight success, but we know it took many days and probably years to make this happen, so let me just say congratulations. The county is fortunate that for our transit, that we have an incredible partner in the Council on Aging, and they've been with us for a long time now, and they are the Treasure Coast Connector. That is the name of their service. Now, many of you know that transit systems typically start out as kind of on demand. That's typically how it starts out, and this one was no exception. But as we're seeing the population grow, we see the demand for fixed routes grow as well. And so this addition is really just a recognition of our growing need for service and our growing population. But there are many things on the horizon that we can be excited about, and let me just mention three to you. This past summer, we had the chance to do a free ride service for the youth of our community. And it was a pilot program that we did over the summer, highly successful, and so we're pleased to announce that will be continuing starting this month, and it will be free going forward. So if you've got an ID card from your school or a library card, you're good to go. I think that's up till the age of 18, correct? I tried to get on, but... So that's important. We talk about, you know, keeping our youth engaged and busy, but if you can't get to the programs that we're providing, that's a problem. And so this is an important step for us to take as we work together. Two other things happening. You know, we've talked about economic development, and one of the things you've got to be able to do is, you know, get to work and then get home from work. And so in concert with the Council on Aging, we are expanding two important services. One is evening services will be provided and starting in January, I believe. And so we are looking at expanding that on our most important routes, our busiest routes. It's one thing to be able to get to work, it's another thing to get home. The world doesn't always work 7 to 6, and so we've got to be able to expand that. It's also true that it doesn't work Monday through Friday, and so we're excited to look at Saturday services as well, and as we begin to figure out where we need to go next, I think that will happen as well. We've got great partners committed to making this happen. It starts with the elected leadership behind me, but it also takes, as I mentioned, the Council on Aging. It also takes our friends at the Florida Department of Transportation. And so, you know, together, we've got many opportunities before us, and I'm just excited about the future. And so with that, let me introduce Jane Ann Petrowski from District 4, Florida Department of Transportation.
Thank you, and good morning to everyone. I just wanted to say that not everyone realizes that the Florida Department of Transportation has a role in supporting and developing transit, but that is part of our mission, and we try to fulfill that here in District 4. In my office, the Office of Modal Development, we believe that we should take every opportunity to increase mobility and accessibility through public transit. So I just wanted to say thank you very much for letting us work with you, and congratulations on the new route, and I'm sure we'll have many new projects in the coming year, so thank you. And I would like to introduce Gerald Drummond.
Thank you, Jane. Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the Board of Directors of the Council on Aging and our staff, we welcome you once again to one of our facilities. We're always excited to have an opportunity to share some of the things that we're doing in the world of transit. Now, even though it seems every time we do something, I'm standing here, believe me, it's the staff that's behind me that are making it happen. And Mariana Bori, our transit director, takes a lot of the credit because she should. She's making those things happen. But as I said some 10 years ago, over on the corner of 7th and Avenue D, that we were going to grow this system, and I'm still around, and it is growing. And I am extremely excited, as Commissioner Lewis indicated, to have a route that now connects us with Indian River County through Lakewood Park. I suspect Commissioner Johnson is excited as well. As Mr. Tipton indicated, we have new things on the horizon. We're excited about continuing the youth program where they ride for free. We're excited about moving to extended services. We're excited in terms of looking in terms of being able to provide transportation on the weekends. We're excited about our partnerships with everyone from DOT right across the board with both cities and the county. I always love to suggest that it's the partnerships that we have which make everything possible. Something that I keep trying to suggest to our friends in Washington, partnerships do work. But we're going to have a tour of the route for anyone who'd like to take a ride after we finish the ribbon cutting. But once again, thank you very much, and I challenge you to come back because we'll be doing this again soon. Thank you. Oh, and now I get to introduce again, for closing remarks, the County Administration, Howard Tipton.
At this time, what I'd like to do is talk about the history of transit. Let me go back to, no, I'm just kidding. Yeah, that would be impressive. I do want to thank our staff. It starts with leadership and Beth and Stephanie and our newest staff person, Mariah. We have a great team, and again, working in partnership, as Mr. Drummond said, it means the world. That's how you get stuff done, and so we're pleased to be able to highlight that. With that, let me invite our elected officials to come forward, and we have a ribbon actually on the bus behind us. We have a very sharp scissors here, which we will handle carefully. We will not run, and we will meet you over at the bus to cut the ribbon.
One, two, three.